old army head. He came home to Tennessee, a young man at the end of 45. Only one of seven men in his platoon that made it back alive. He must have seen some tough times, but he never talked too much about all that. Put his pictures and his memories in his new chest. Everything but his old army hat. By the time I'd graduated, the winds of change had blown across our land. They were burning flags and draft cards, but they wanted to take some kind of stand. And we used to laugh at Grandpa like he was some old relic from the past. 'Cause he never left the house unless he was married. That funny looking old army hat. Oh, my grandpa didn't care. I ain't feeling this for them, he said. It's a whole lot more than that. For my buddies who gave everything, the least that I can do is keep on wearing this old army hat. Up one morning, said he'd seen it on the news on his TV. They've opened up a monument to World War II in Washington, D.C. I ain't getting any younger, and I wish someone would take me to see that. I couldn't help but think they're gonna laugh at you up there if you show up in that city. Two strangers both saluted as Grandpa walked up to the monument. One said, "Thank you, soldier, for the job well done." The other said, "Amen." And the young boy said, "Sir, my daddy went to war and never made it back. Would you take a picture standing here beside me? Maybe let me wear your army hat." FBI was on me, but there was not a dry bone in the crowd. They whispered a name, and Grandpa stood up extra tall and proud. He said, "Son, just keep it, but the young one tried his best to get it back. You're a brave little soldier, son, and every soldier needs his very own authentic army hat. For your daddy who gave everything, the least that I can do is pass on this old worn-out army hat." Our spacious forever.